Inventing is a mysterious calling. A combination of ingenuity, hard work, and a different way of thinking. Dr. Erwin Sick was a passionate inventor. It was his idea to combine optics with electronics in order to harness the power of human vision in the monitoring of machines and emissions.
At Siemens, for example, they had produced electrical devices. And at Zeiss, in Jena, they assembled optical cameras and binoculars. But combining the two technologies into one device to create a sensor was a new idea. It was an innovation that my husband essentially came up with.
The origins of his company go back to a small barracks.
Steinheil, a large optics firm in Munich, where my husband had worked as a development engineer, built emergency shelters in Vaterstetten, outside of Munich. We lived in a barracks measuring 20 square meters. And next to it was another one of the same size, connected by a small corridor built by my husband. This is where he had his books, library, drawing board, and even a small lathe that he had bought so he could do his tinkering.
From 1949, in a bid to attract business leads, he attended various trade fairs. One year later, he received an important assignment to find a better way of protecting workers' fingers in cutting machines. Since the 1930s, the solution to this problem had been the photoelectric sensor. But Dr. Erwin Sick was working on a better solution. In 1950, he saw a beacon rotating at the former Munich Ream Airport. In the hazy air, he observed the light beam in motion. From this observation, he developed the autocollimation principle and revolutionized safety technology.
My husband then had the idea of using not only protective photoelectric sensors, where you can still reach into the gaps with your hands, but also to install a light curtain, which has a fast rotating light beam in front of it. This device would completely prevent you from reaching into the machine. So if somebody tried to reach through this so-called light curtain, the machine would shut down. And it took the show by storm at the Hanover Messe Trade Fair, the protective light curtain and what you could do with it. And soon enough, orders were coming in from large firms.
This invention meant the breakthrough for the young company. Over the following years and decades, Sick developed more and more efficient protective devices, which are now used in virtually all industries to ensure the safety of workers and machinery. Dr. Erwin Sick believed in the effectiveness of optoelectronic technology. So in 1951, he also invented a device that could detect print marks on packaging materials. This made it possible to automate the food manufacturing and packaging process. The company built on this foundation to become one of the world's leading manufacturers of sensors for the automation of production and logistics processes. Dr. Erwin Sick was also a pioneer when it came to protecting the environment. As early as 1958, he developed a device which could measure smoke emissions in smokestacks. This marked the birth of environmental measurement technology at Sick.
In the Ruhr area, in the 20s and 30s, for example, I had relatives in Dortmund telling me that they couldn't hang out their laundry because it would go black from all the smoke. But the days hanging out the laundry are no longer a problem because they managed to get exhaust emissions under control.
Today, products and systems from Sick harness the most efficient technologies to carry out measurements. And when it comes to monitoring emissions and providing reliable environmental protection, the world's first choice for measurements is Sick. The commercial success of these products has led to rapid growth for the company. Since 1956, the new home of Sick has been in the German town of Waldkirch. And to this day, the headquarters of Sick AG remain in the southwest of Germany. 1972 saw the start of the company's internationalization with the founding of its first subsidiary in France. Over the years that followed, the company expanded to the US and Asia. Today, Sick AG employs over 7,400 people and has a global presence. And in addition to Europe and the US, development of sensor solutions has also begun in Asia. With over 40,000 products, Sick offers its customers the largest product and technology portfolio in the industry. What began with the functionality of a single product has developed into complex system solutions with a range of services from a single source. This full range package has turned Sick into the recognized expert and market leader for industrial sensors in over 40 key industries.
The recipe for success, from the small barracks to a global market leader, has a few basic rules. The main one being that we will never forget the past and are conscious of our heritage. Development and innovation were the reason for Sick coming into being, and this has not changed today. At the same time, we have always adopted technological developments, as well as adding new ones, from optics to a wide variety of sensor technologies. As a result, today we have 7 divisions for different technologies and a solid segment-based organization with factory automation, logistics automation, and process automation.
At Sick, industry experts work together with technology experts to develop tailored solutions for their customers. The result? Satisfied customers and over 100,000 applications put into practice. In order to supply solutions to an international market even more quickly, the company's logistics processes underwent further development too. Work that took a lot of effort to carry out manually back then is now fully automated. Over 40,000 customers in Europe, as well as the 6 subsidiaries across the globe, are supplied from the new distribution center. In 2013, the company achieved a major milestone when it reached sales of over 1 billion euros. But this is not the first time Sick has been in the headlines. From today, the first 10 of 27 signal bridges will look after traffic on the A4 between Cologne and Aachen, which is a black spot for accidents. The traffic control system, which is going into operation today, will warn drivers of fog banks in good time. A number of fog sensors will continuously measure visual ranges, sending relevant data to a central computer administered by the local government authority in Cologne. In 1988, Dr. Erwin Sick died of a heart attack at the age of 79. His wife, Gisela Sick, promptly made it clear that she would continue her husband's lifetime achievement. Without any interruption, she has supervised the company up to the present day as honorary chair of the supervisory board. As a mother of 3 children, the wife of a restless inventor, and now a business person herself, she has led an eventful life.
I honestly have to tell you, I was never bored in my life, and even today, I am not.
Moreover, with the changes related to Industry 4.0, the company is going through exciting times. The prerequisite for an intelligent factory, in which processes are optimized automatically, is data.
The idea is to use data to develop new solutions for customers. And from a technical standpoint, the sensor is by definition the supplier of data. This means we are a direct prerequisite to even make Industry 4.0 possible in technical fields.
As a founding member of industrial data space and having already developed IO-Link in 2006, Sick and its almost 900 engineers are preparing intelligent sensor technology for the interconnected world of the future. Over the past 70 years, the business that Dr. Erwin Sick started as an engineering office has developed numerous innovative solutions. Just as it has always done, Sick will continue striving in the future to make the impossible a reality with countless ideas and a great deal of courage.